So we've seen what is a point in geometry. It's something that has a location or a position, but does not have any size, length, or width. There's no movement when you're on a point. Now imagine you're standing on this point and you need to move around. Obviously, you'll need more points to connect to this point and maybe you'll make a path. So let's imagine if you had to go from this point to one more point somewhere far away, what would the path be like? So you see the difference between these two paths. Let me call this path A and let me call this path B. You see that in both of these movements or paths, you move from this starting point to this end point, and same here. But there's something special with the path A actually looks like a curve, and this is something about which you'll study later on. But the path B that you have in front of you is what we call a line segment. I know it looks like a line, something that we use this word in day-to-day life, but it's actually called a line segment. And what's special about this is that it's actually the shortest distance between this first point here and this last point here. And you can actually call these two points as endpoints, whether you're moving from left to right or from right to left. So you see that a line segment is nothing but a collection of all the points put together from one point to another. Now let me show you one more thing. Something that looks a little more neater. So take a look at how we are connecting these points together. The important idea here is that from a basic fundamental building block of geometry that we call a point, you're putting it together, a lot of them together, and forming a segment. You'll take the segment, put them together, and maybe form polygons. So basically, you're building shapes. So I hope that's clear, but wait, I have something else for you.